Hey, I'm Andy, and this is Nail Guitar, the channel where I teach you to play songs acoustically so that you can play them without a band. As with all my lessons, I have a free song lesson guide for you. It's free to grab via the description down below or in the first comment. Why have I created it for you? To make your learning faster and easier. It's also great for quick reference later when you inevitably forget parts of the song. It's what I use if I'm going to perform a song, so go and grab it now. When you do, you'll also get access to song lesson guides for every other song I've taught here on the channel over the past 10 years. While others require that you join their Patreon and pay a monthly fee for this, I don't do that. I want you to succeed in learning songs. To put the final cherry on top, I'll also send you my Easy Songs Cheat Sheet, a guide to the 66 easiest songs I've taught here on the channel, so that you can get some quick wins and build momentum. Grab the song lesson guide now. I'll be making reference to it as we go through the lesson. So Hall of Fame, what have we got here for our chords? We have E minor, C, G, and D. For our rhythm, it's what I call a 3-3-2 rhythm. The accents are in bunches of 3-3, then 2. 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2, 1-2-3, 1-2-3, 1-2. And the pattern is down, down, up, down, 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 up, down, 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 up. If you can do that, you're in a good position to put all this together. The good news is, most of the song is the same thing. So those chords that we ran through, with that rhythm. So we've got E minor, C, G, D. If I go slowly with the rhythm, E minor, C, G, D. And later on, I'll show you some little variations that you can do to make it more interesting. But the core of this is, if we've got the same thing for the verse and the chorus, we need to create some dynamics. So aside from strumming lighter in the verse and heavier in the chorus, utilizing a bit of palm muting is a great way to really give that some dynamic, make it more percussive in the chorus before we open it up. So, being really heavy-handed on the strings there towards the bridge to create that percussive vibe. Last time. So instead of E, C, G, D for that fourth round, it's E, C, and we skip the G, straight to D. And then we're into our chorus. Open it up, make it big. What can we do to make that more interesting for us, aside from the dynamics, which is always the most important thing? You don't always have to go, you know, doing chordal variations, so it is important that I mention that. First thing that jumps to me is doing a C add 9. For some people, you may even find this a little easier. Not that E minor to C should be a tricky one, but because we've got our second finger there. Nice little variation because it's so close to G as well. If you really want to tie it all together, keeping the third finger for the E minor, the C add 9, the G and the D, actually all four chords, you can keep that third finger there, which then gives you a nice E minor 7. With the G, you also have the option of taking away that fourth finger, which gives you a G6. And you also have that option with the open string on the D. And then, you know, you can really spice that up. Maybe you want to do that more arpeggiated style for the verse. You wanted to get real fancy? Where is it? There's that key line, which is over the G chord. So it kind of look like a bit like a G7. And so we're not gonna play that, not gonna set up our first finger for a G7. We're gonna do this line on the B string. And that's open one, 3rd fret. If you want to get so fancy. So there it is for your Hall of Fame. If you enjoyed it, of course, hit that like button, subscribe, do that good karma thing, and catch me for future lessons here on the channel. Hit the ding-a-ling bell, of course, otherwise you won't get notified. And at its simplest, this song is just E minor, C, G, D. Would you like an amazing list of easy song lessons to give you momentum to get you going there with the chords listed for each of those songs of all the songs that I've taught here on the channel over the years? Well, it's called the Easy Songs Cheat Sheet and it's available for you to grab absolutely free. The link is in the description down below or in the first comment. See you for more lessons soon. My name's Andy. Save countless hours searching for easy songs to learn and download my Easy Songs Cheat Sheet. Click the link in the description now to get it absolutely free.